Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the Fourier transform. So this Fourier transform is very important tool for the frequency domain analysis of the signal. And for understanding some basics of this communication, this Fourier transform is very useful. So far in the earlier videos, we had seen that using this Fourier series, we can find the frequency spectra of any periodic signal. The periodic signal repeat itself after some finite time and it exists from minus infinity to plus infinity. But all the practical signals are the aperiodic because they start at some finite time and they also end at the particular time. For example, if we take the case of the speech signal, then it exists only for the finite duration. That means almost all practical signals are the aperiodic signal. And for such aperiodic signal, we can find the frequency spectra using the Fourier transform. So let's say we have this aperiodic signal and we want to find the frequency spectra of this aperiodic signal. And let's say this signal exists from the time t1 to t2. So using the generalized expression of the Fourier transform, we can find the frequency spectra of this aperiodic signal. But to understand this Fourier transform little bit in detail, let us start with the exponential Fourier series. And if we apply certain limiting process, then this aperiodic signal can be represented as the summation of these complex exponentials. So for that, let us define the new periodic signal from this aperiodic signal. So as you can see, this new signal gt of t repeat itself after the one time period. And since this signal gt of t is the periodic signal, so we can represent this signal by the summation of the complex exponentials. And here, the contribution of each complex exponential can be found using this expression. Now here if you observe, this periodic signal is integrated over the one time period, right? But instead of integrating this periodic signal, if we integrate this aperiodic signal from minus infinity to plus infinity, then it will give us the same result, right? So we can write this Cn as 1 by t0 integration gt of t e to the power minus j times n omega naught t dt. And using this expression, we can find the coefficients at the different frequencies. And let's say for the given signal, these are the coefficients. Now here, if we double the time period of this signal, that means if t0 dash is equal to 2 times t0, then the frequency will get halved, right? And here, since the time period has been doubled, so the amplitude or the weightage of the each coefficient will also reduce. And as we increase the time period of the signal, then the spectral components will get closer and closer. Or in other words, we can say that the frequency spectrum will get denser. And as this time period t0 tends to infinity, that means when the signal repeats itself after the infinite time period, then we can say that here this gt of t is equal to g of t. That means as t0 tends to infinity, then the spectral components are no longer discrete. That means in that case, we will get the continuous frequency spectrum. And now, since this frequency spectrum is continuous, so we cannot define the frequency components by this Cn. So this continuous frequency spectrum can be defined by the following expression. And this expression shows the Fourier transform of the signal g of t. That means if we take the Fourier transform of the signal g of t, then we will get the continuous function g of f in the frequency domain. So far what we did, from this aperiodic signal, we generated the new periodic signal. And for this periodic signal, by assuming t0 tends to infinity, we got the expression of the Fourier transform. Similarly, if we know the frequency spectrum of any signal, then using the inverse Fourier transform, we can reconstruct that signal in the time domain. So this inverse Fourier transform can be given as integration minus infinity to plus infinity g of f e to the power j times omega t times df. So this expression shows the inverse Fourier transform. So now let us talk a little bit about this inverse Fourier transform. And to understand it, we will continue with our previous example. So as I said, if we have the periodic signal gt of t, then it can be expressed as the linear combination of the complex exponentials. And here, the weightage or the contribution of each component can be given by this expression. So here, this Cn shows the frequency components of the signal gt of t, while this expression shows the frequency spectrum of the aperiodic signal g of t. Now, as I said earlier, this Cn can be written as 1 by t0 integration minus infinity to infinity g of t times e to the power minus j times n omega t dt. So if we compare this expression with g of f, then we can write it as Cn is equal to 1 by t0 times g of nf0. And here, this expression shows the samples of the continuous function g of f, which is taken at the interval of f0. That means if we put the value of n is equal to 1, then we will get the value of c1, which is the sample of this function g of f taken at the f0. And likewise, by putting the different values of n, we will get the sample of this function g of f at the different intervals. So now, let us put this value of cn in this summation. That means we can write this expression as gt of t is equal to summation of n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity 1 by t0 times g of nf0 times e to the power j times n omega naught t. Now here, as t0 tends to infinity, then we can say that this f0 tends to 0. And when this f0 tends to 0, then the more meaningful representation of this f0 is equal to delta f. So considering this, when this t0 tends to infinity, then we can write this expression as summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity this delta f times g of n delta f times e to the power j times n times this omega naught is equal to 2 pi times f naught. That means we can write it as 2 pi times delta f times t. So this is the expression of this gt of t when this t0 tends to infinity. And graphically, if we see this expansion, then this small segment represents the n delta f. That means it is the frequency n delta f. And at that frequency, if we see the amplitude, then it is equal to g of n delta f. And the width of this segment is equal to delta f. So as this delta f tends to 0, then we can say that this n delta f is equal to f. Because in that case, all this segment gets merged and we will get the continuous spectrum. So when this delta f tends to 0, or when this t0 tends to infinity, then this summation can be replaced by the integration. And as t0 tends to infinity, then as we have seen, this gt of t is equal to g of t. And we can write this expression as gt of t is equal to minus infinity to infinity g of f times e to the power j times omega t times df, where this omega is equal to 2 pi f. So in this way, we got the expression of the inverse Fourier transform. So in the next video, we will see some of the important properties of the Fourier transform, which are particularly useful in the communication. But I hope in this video, you understood the concept of the Fourier transform. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.